Cervical cancer is a cancer of the opening to the woman's uterus. In the United States, we've been very successful through cancer screening to be able to decrease the incidence of cervical cancer and to decrease the number of women who die from this disease. Over the past several years, we've found that the vast majority, over 99%, of all cervical cancers are caused by a virus called human papillomavirus. This virus is sexually transmitted. You get it from having sex with someone who has the virus. It's extremely common in the population. 40 to 50 million American women have the virus. Most of them will never get an abnormal pap smear, but it is a necessary but not sufficient condition to cause them to get cancer. There are other conditions that can help in the development of cancer. Smoking is one risk factor. The immune system of a woman is another risk factor. It doesn't seem to be related to the family history, but more to her exposure to the disease. Well, the primary screening tool is a pap smear. It's a test that was developed by a Dr. Papanikolaou, that's how it got its name, is the pap smear, where we take cells from the surface of the cervix and send them to the pathologist. They're able to identify early changes that could lead in future years to the development of cervical cancer. That gives us a chance to intervene before it becomes a cancer, so that women who are regularly screened tend to have an extremely low incidence of cervical cancer. That is something that's evolved over the recent years as we found more about the natural history and progression of the disease. Recent advances have shown that young women have an ability through their own immune system to fight off the disease, and it's extremely uncommon to find a cervical cancer in a woman under age 21. This has allowed us to make a new recommendation that women under age 21 do not need cervical cancer screening. So the pap smear does not need to be initiated before age 21. I think most women are acquainted with a recommendation that they have a yearly pap smear. Well, that may be a recommendation that has seen its last days. Recommendations now are that in your 20s, the pap smears are every 2 years, and after attaining age 30, if a patient has had 3 consecutive negative pap smears, she can elect to go to once every 3 years for pap smear frequency. One of the advances in preventing cervical cancer has been the development of a vaccine against the human papillomavirus. There are multiple subtypes of the virus. There's a high-risk type and low-risk type, and the high-risk type are the ones that cause cervical cancer. They have been able to isolate the most frequent of those and make a vaccine to treat that. The vaccine will cover 70% of the high-risk viruses, and we're currently recommending that young women aged 12 and 13 receive the vaccine for the virus, and it can be given to young women between the age of 9 and 26. You know, now that we've made the recommendation that you only need a pap smear every 2 years in your 20s or every 3 years in your 30s and beyond, I hear a lot of delight from women out there saying, oh good, I don't need to go in and have my pelvic exam. Unfortunately, that's not the case. Cervical cancer screening is not the only reason to come in for an exam. At your annual exam with your doctor, he can review some of the health problems that you may be experiencing. Young women, while they don't need to be screened for cervical cancer, do need to be screened for sexually transmitted diseases. Women of reproductive age have concerns whether they're trying to get pregnant or trying to avoid pregnancy, and we can address those issues as well. As the menstrual periods changes, there are things that can be done to address the menstrual periods and make them more tolerable. There's other diseases that are noted in both the vulva, and the vagina, the ovaries, and the uterus, which can be screened on an annual exam. If we don't see you and don't have a chance to examine you, we can't address these other issues. So it's not simply the pap smear that you're coming in for. There's many things that we can handle when you come in for your annual exam.
For more information about this physician or to schedule an appointment, please call our referral line or visit westvalleyisbetter.com.